What happened to our women? Women who could have been doctors or lawyers or teachers or mothers.
This is St. George's Castle or Elmina Castle. It is the biggest and the oldest in the world when you talk of transatlantic slave trade. It was built by the Portuguese in 1482. And to them, they had two reasons basically why they built it. One for trade and two for missionary work. Initially, we were trading in gold, in ivory and later spices. So all the rooms on the ground floor were being used as storerooms or warehouses. However, in the early 16th centuries, it shifted from the gold and others to human trade. And when it got started, the same storerooms were then transformed or converted to holding cells or dungeons where the Africans were kept. In total, the castle had a minimum of 1,000 captives at a time. This section of the castle was the female section. We're talking of 400 people here at the time. Now, we need to understand that when the Portuguese and the Dutch came over here to trade, most of them never brought their wives. Over here also, they could not stay without them. So the governors, the soldiers, the traders kept on abusing the women here in the dungeons. Whenever the governor wanted, because of his position, he just came and stood up on the balcony there and ordered. Women were taken from the dungeons all over here to this courtyard. So from there, he just looked through and then made his choice. The woman chosen could have stayed in the dungeons for a whole month. And all the time in there, there was not a single location she could clean her feet. She never took a bath or bathing. She had gone through the menstrual cycle. Yet she's the one chosen by the governor. So then it became the responsibility of the soldiers to clean her. How did they do it? They fetched water from the cistern. They washed the woman at the center of the courtyard, whilst all women from the dungeons looked on. After the humiliation, she was dressed up, given something to eat, and she was taken up the stairs there. We call it the private access to the governor's bedroom. After the governor had used her in most cases, he never stayed with her. So after she was brought back to the dungeons. Instances, the story says that before the woman moved from the governor's place to the dungeons, soldiers bringing her had taken advantage of her. So the least you could say is that before she got back, she could have been used by several men. And those that became pregnant were subsequently freed or liberated. We need to understand they came not only from today's what is known to be Ghana alone, but also from entire West African sub-region. So when the woman was free, she could not move back to where she came from. Secondly, the Europeans never wanted their own babies to go wayward or astray. So some houses were built here in the town where those found pregnant were kept. And here now in Elmina, we are still having people bearing names like Da Costa, Da Silva, De Vere, Vroom Smith, Hutchinson, Peterson, and such other European names. Here is a cannonball. Eight of such were all over here before. Each one of them had chains on it, and they were used to punish the women who to them were very difficult to handle. And in those days, when they said the woman was difficult, in most cases, she refused or resisted from a soldier. So for refusing or resisting, she was pulled out of the dungeons to the courtyard, chained to the ankles or the legs with two cannonballs. And be it rain or shine, she was made to stand in it for as long as they wanted, no food as punishment. And since we all came from a woman, got our name from a woman, and I came from a woman. I wonder why we take from our women, why we rape our women, do we hate our women? I think it's time to kill for our women, time to heal our women, be real to our women.
Thank you. slave. I'm a runaway slave. I'm a runaway slave.